This is part three of square roots and radicals, and I'm just going to go over how we might approximate a square root of a number that is not a perfect square. For instance, we do know the perfect squares, remember, like 0 squared, 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared, 4 squared, etc. So this goes on forever. So 0, 1, 4, 9, 16, those are called perfect squares because they're squares of whole numbers. Okay, so we're starting with the whole number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And that's how we decide what the perfect squares are. All right, so the question is, what if we take something and we want to take the square root of it, but it's not a perfect square? So first of all, like square root of 4, that is a perfect square, so it's 2. Square root of 25 is 5, etc., right? No problem. The problem is, what do you do with the square root of, let's say, 19? What the heck is that? Okay, well, the first thing is to note that 19 is not a perfect square because there's no number when you multiply by itself. You're going to get 19, in other words, no whole number. So if it's not a whole number in here, it means it's not rational. So we'd say this is an irrational number. But we can estimate approximately where it is. So we're going to look at the square root of 19 again. And we're going to think of it this way. We're going to try to figure out approximately what two numbers it's in between. You might even think about where would it be on the number line. Where would square root of 19 be on the number line? So let's say this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. I don't know where it is. Well, we're going to try to think of the perfect square just before 19 and the perfect square right after 19. So of course you have to know your perfect squares. I'm going to list those over here again, starting with 4, 0 and 1, those are the, well, let's start with 1, 1 squared, and then 4, 9, 16, 25, 36. Notice I'm just doing 5 squared, 6 squared, 7 squared, 8 squared, 9 squared, etc. This goes on and on and on. Those are the perfect squares. So 19 is between which two of those numbers? Well, it's in between 16, right? And 25, 19, the number 19, which is underneath the square root, is in between 16 and 25. So therefore, the square root of 16 is smaller than the square root of 19, which is smaller than the square root of 25. So, square root of 16, well, that's a perfect square, 16. So the square root of 16 is 4, right? And the square root of 25 we could simplify. So therefore, we know square root of 19 is somewhere between the number 4 and 5. So, we know it's somewhere in this area, right? Square root of 19 has to be somewhere in there. And you could approximate it, I don't know exactly where it is, but it looks like it might be a little bit closer to 4. So, maybe it's here, for instance. That might be the square root of 19. All right, so that's the technique. So let's do it on another number. Let's say we wanted to know where the square root of 40 was. Okay, 40 is not a perfect square. So what we do is think of, what's the perfect square just below 40? And actually, if you get that one, you're going to be able to automatically get the next one. The square root of 36 is 6. So if we're trying to find two whole numbers it's in between. So it's in between 6 and 7, right? You could just stop right there, or if you want, you could put in the 49. So basically, you could say square root of 40 is between, oops, I don't know what's going on with my tablet here. Square root of 40 is between 6 and 7. So we're not getting exactly, I'm not saying it's 6.5 or 6.2 or 6.9, etc., although we can do that as well. But right now I'm just saying, how are we going to figure out a couple numbers that's in between? All right, so what I want you to tell me is I want you to fill in the blanks with whole numbers. So we're looking for consecutive whole numbers. Fill in the blanks with consecutive whole numbers to approximate value of each square root. All right, so square root of 12, you have to think of the perfect square under 12. Well, that would be square root of 9, right? So this means it should be in between 3 and 4. Make sense? And the reason over here is because square root of 9 is less than square root of 12, which is less than the square root of 16. That's the reasoning. Okay? How about square root of 70? You think of the perfect square under 70, that's 64, so it must be between 8 and 9. Same reasoning, because square root of 64 is less than square root of 70 is less than the square root of 81. So that's the reason. And now you approximately know where square root of 70 is, and it's probably it's 8 point something. Now what you could do is actually get out your calculator, put in the square root of 70, and see what comes up. So to check yourself, you can actually use a calculator, do the square root of 70, and in my calculator I have 8.36660026 5, and it really does go on forever and ever. But you could see it's a little bigger than 8, right? So it makes sense that we estimated correctly that square root of 70 is between 8 and 9. But here's the thing to really pay attention to. This is not exactly square root of 70, 8.37 or 8.36660026 5. It really does go on forever and ever. So for you to note that that's just an approximation, if I took 8.3666, let's say I just went that far and I squared that in my calculator, I get 69.999999556. So you know what? It's pretty darn close, but it's not exactly 70, right? So when you're using a calculator, it gives you approximations. When I'm saying it's between 8 and 9, that's also simply an approximation. The exact answer for square root of 70 is just as you see it, the square root of 70. Calculator will only give you an approximation. Pretty good approximation, too. All right, let's do this. Let's use a calculator to approximate each square root to the nearest thousandth. All right, so why don't you try that with your calculator? All right, and I'm going to do it to the nearest thousandth. You should have gotten 3.873. Remember, the thousandths is three places after your decimal point. Now, on your calculator, it probably comes out to 3.87298, blah, blah, blah. But remember, you're going to have to round that up to 3 at the thousandths place. All right, next step, take that approximation, 3.873, and square it. So we're going to take 3.873 and square it. And I have 15.000129. So it's not exactly 15. It's a little bit bigger than 15, but it was a pretty good approximation, this 3.873. But what I want to make sure you understand, that that's not exactly the square root of 15. All right, try it for the square root of 30. All right, if you approximate, you should get 5.477. And so now we're going to take that 5.477 in your calculator and square it. So 5.477 squared is exactly 29.997529. That's just a little bit under 30, but it's pretty close, right? But it's not exact. So notice when I rounded up, like for the square root of 15, when I squared that number, it was a little over 15. For number square root of 30, when I rounded, kept it the same, I did not round up the thousandths place, when I squared that approximation, I get a number just a little bit less than 30. Good approximations, but do remember these are approximations, they're not exact. And if you have a number in front of the square root, like 2 times square root of 3, this means 2 times the square root of 3. So to get this answer, I'm going to have to do 2 times an approximation for the square root of 3. So let's go to the nearest thousandths again for the square root of 3. If you approximate it, you get 1.732. And so if I multiply that by 2, 2 times 1.732, you get 3.464. So that's a pretty good approximation, right? But if you wouldn't have approximated first, all right, in other words, you put in the square root of 3 into your calculator, you leave it, and you multiply by 2, you will get 3.464101615. It's not exactly the same, it's still pretty close. So it kind of depends if you approximate and then multiply by 2, or you leave it the square root of 2 in your calculator and then do the approximation. All right, so that's how to approximate square roots.